In the excitement, no one noticed Mr. Gruber's arrival, which wasn't surprising because he was almost completely hidden behind an enormous parcel. "I'm sorry I'm late, Mr. Prown," he puffed. "I've been having quite a job with your present." He gave the others a broad wink. "It's very heavy, and I didn't want to break any records." Paddington grew more and more excited as he tore open the paper, and when he saw what was inside, he nearly fell over backwards with surprise, for it seemed to be some kind of wooden box. But not just any old wooden box, for there was a handle on the side, rather like the starting handle of an old car, and on top it had the biggest horn he'd ever seen in his life. "Thank you very much, Mr. Gruber," he exclaimed doubtfully as he took a deep breath. "I don't think I've ever played one of these before, but I'll have a go." "Careful, Mr. Prown," cried Mr. Gruber, but it was too late. "Ooh," cried Paddington. "Help! Let me out!" "Oh, dear," said Mr. Gruber. "Young Mr. Prown seems to have got his head stuck in the horn." While Mrs. Bird, with the aid of some of the others, plus a liberal supply of butter, helped free Paddington, Mr. Gruber went on to explain about his present. "It's an old-fashioned gramophone, Mr. Brown," he said. "You don't blow it, you wind it up. Like so. It's been in the back of my shop for some years now, and there's even an old record to go with it. Guaranteed to help young bears go to sleep quickly. Let me play it to you while you sit back and recover."